they've already deepened. You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please!
You'll be just fine with these. Celica enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Celica is safe. It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Laffy's older sister, and you're a student.
On that day, the world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
Laffy, time to wake up.
Okay.
Morning.
I told you to stop calling me Laffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good. Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today. Until then, you stay in bed, got it?
What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape.
Sorry, you'll have to wait.
Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to.
Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money'll have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself, then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my students' abilities. Sorry to put you in a spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening.
Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
If I'm on the hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Laffy's medicine, so I can't mess this up. Rest up, all right?
Don't forget to take some gels with you. You know, you're careless sometimes.
I'll be fine. You just make sure.
Don't worry about me. I'll be in bed resting.
You better be. Keep warm, and no going outside.
Sheesh, you don't trust me at all. It'll get dark if you don't leave soon.
Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. Maybe he's just worn out? That does it! I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. That ought to pick him right up. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers and weariness alike.
Ever since the opening 7 years ago, this world's ripped famine, freezing weather, and worst of all, this demon blight that's turning people into monsters.
I can't believe that people can really turn into those things. It's a nightmare.
Does no one know what causes demon blight? Or how to heal it?
No. What we do know is that when people turn into those monsters, I mean, demons, they gain incredible strength and attack humans on sight.
Huh. Whoever named it the opening named it right. It's like someone opened a portal directly to hell.
Come to think of it, Celica died during the opening, didn't she? It might be a good thing she died when she did. She didn't have to suffer through all of this.
It's good that my sister died? How can you say that?
Sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
You're a real idiot, you know that?
Sorry about him, Velvet.
Hey, Velvet. Is Lafayette feeling better?
No, not yet. He needs a little more rest, I think.
Aw, too bad. Tell him I'm looking forward to hunting beetles with him again when he's better.
Right, got it.
Lafayette's illness sure is persistent.
Yeah, that fever still keeps coming back, like clockwork. The medicine always helps a little bit, but still.
That sounds terrible. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help.
Thanks, but we'll be fine. At least we've got Arthur to take care of anything that needs muscle. And before he came, Celica raised me and Laffy all by herself. So now I have to do my best too.
You sound just like your sister. That optimism must run in the family.
I do? That's nice of you to say. I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest. I don't have a lot of money to spare, but like Arthur always says, battles are won and lost with the preparations made before the first strike.
The demon blight is a punishment sent to us by the Empyreans for forgetting the old prayers.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
All right, then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course, of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16. This area looks promising.
There! Prickle Boar!
Weather's been terrible on everyone's crops, but at least the city will buy our prickle boar meat now. Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them, but they can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred with more docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkle boars? Nah, doesn't sound appetizing. What about pickle boar? Yeah, pickle boar! That's a cute name. Maybe too cute, though. We wouldn't want to discourage people from eating them. Enough to cover the medicine. I'd better bring these to the store. This place isn't safe. That hole's gotten bigger. I've told them 1,000 times they ought to build a fence, but they keep saying it's forbidden land. Even Celica used to scare me with it. She was always, "This is a gateway to the underworld." Well, I'm too old to keep falling for that nonsense. Wait, the boars I hunted, are you there? Maxim 3, never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle! An exorcist art!
Pride and anxiety, pity for the enemy, thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
Arthur?
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine. I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of-
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. I wonder if those prickle boars were brothers. Maybe I should have let them go. But then, how would I pay for Laffy's medicine? Hunting took care of that. And it means food for us as well. I had no other choice. It was a rational decision. But the fact that I'm still worrying about it shows that my feelings are getting the better of me. Here for groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out hunting.
Yeah, it was a good haul.
Look at you, Lady Breadwinner. If you were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah? You ought to do something about your style, then.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb.
So get a new one.
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
What? Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh, what is wrong with Midgand? I mean, don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
But... we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore. Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, here, on the house.
You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche.
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious?
Please. This is life or death for me.
But I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
Who cares what people think? The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right!
Luffy must be starving by now. I'd better hurry home. Dorothy and Russ seem pretty down today.
I know. They've been whimpering like this for an hour now.
Well, they've always been a bit wimpy. The other day, that kitty Rollo chased both of them up a tree by himself.
They're hopeless. Whenever it's thundering out, they both dive into my bed, shivering.
Orthy, Russ, shape up. You're Nico's bodyguards, right? Start acting like it.
They're completely hopeless.
Maybe.
But they're so cute.
So I forgive them.
Celica taught you how to make your special quiches, right, Velvet?
Yeah, but mine aren't nearly as good as hers.
Don't be modest! They're fantastic! Simple, yet elegant.
That's because there's a secret in the cheese and the dough.
You should try selling them in Taliesin. I'm sure they'd be a hit. We could make them together and take them on the road! We could even wear matching uniforms!
Would it make more money than hunting Fricklebores?
Definitely maybe! Even more so if you could lighten up a bit in front of the customers.
Then it might be worth a try. I do want to buy Laffy a nice heavy winter coat. And Arthur's gloves are in tatters, so he needs new ones.
Oh, don't be so boring! I get where you're coming from, but come on! Think big! Dream, Velvet! Dream!
Think big? No thanks. I want a peaceful life with Laffy and Arthur. That's all.
You're impossible. Then again, maybe that's why your quiches taste so darn good.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. And the baby you carried. Oh, drat. I forgot to bring your princessias. I know how much you, Mom, and Dad all loved those flowers. And I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some from the Cape tomorrow.
Welcome home, Velvet.
Laffy, I told you to stay in bed.
I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the ocean. See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the waves. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Laffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh. You really can talk to Malakim, can't you?
Yeah. Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him. I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world. I'll hunt and chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you. I wish I could do that.
Oh,
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... 20 years, tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh yeah? You better prove it to me then. Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove. It's so easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
Huh. You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know. But just for today?
Fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once. And I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet!
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there? Isn't this Arthur's book? Is Luffy really reading stuff this dense? Poor kid's gonna squint his eyes right out.
The day before Scarlet Night, Sis went prickle boar hunting on her own. She's almost as good a fighter as Arthur, so I know those prickle boars don't stand a chance. But I worry that she's too athletic to land a husband. Maybe she should try to be more ladylike.
Little scamp. He just knew I'd be reading this, didn't he? There you go. Not spicy hot, but oh so delicious. Oh yeah, I saw Nico today, and she had very important things to talk about. She's coming over in the next couple days, so be on your best behavior.
I will. I'm glad you've got a good friend.
Yeah, we've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Luffy, you know, if there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big Sister all about it, right?
A girl?
You're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older girl to keep you under control. Oh, and she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen is a success at life.
Knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me? I've got enough on my mind. For one thing, I've gotta cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men? I just don't see what's so... Luffy, what's wrong? Are you all right? I'll bring you some water.
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all, and it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah. But what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you too. I want you to be happy, that's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready. Good boy, you didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise.
Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Yeah, just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet, may I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course.
Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? Not have gone to the village alone. I bet your fever hasn't even gone down. Hey, has Lafayette been here?
No. I haven't seen him.
Wait, that's one of Arthur's.
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand? Oh, he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet, I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest.
I was going to have them join the search, but they won't move at all. It's like they're scared of something.
I know. He might have gone to the cape to pick flowers. Have you seen Lafayette?
Nope. Can't say that I have.
All right. Let me know the second you see him.
Got it. Is he in bad shape?
Well, he refuses to stay in bed. He needs his rest, but he's always walking around or reading outside.
I can't say I'm surprised. He's always been a curious lad. He likes reading difficult books. When I saw him the other day, he told me all about the latest navigation techniques and exotic farming methods, too. Only one kid in a million is as smart as he is.
You're exaggerating. Well, maybe not.
It's a shame. If he could go to school in the capital, I'm sure he'd make a name for himself as a scholar.
The capital? Isn't that days and days by ship from Taliesin? No way! Not happening. Even if he gets better. I could never let him go that far away all by himself.
He can handle it. He's actually a very responsible boy. I don't think you need to worry.
I couldn't handle it. I would worry. And be lonely.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to be another Scarlet Night!
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago. But what is it anyway?
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one by watching the movements of the stars. According to legend, a crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof of humanity's sins.
You sure know a lot about it.
Lafayette taught me just a few minutes ago.
You saw Lafayette? Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
I was just taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Lafayette. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the Cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
Remember how we went out together to pick Princessias on the morning of Celica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only 4, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of course I did. Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too?
You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you. He'll help the world. He's quite the guy.
That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe.
I know. I'm sorry, sis.
But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of Princessia were blooming.
I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica.
That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what Princessia flowers signify?
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come.
Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Lafayette.
Yeah. Me too, sis.
Is that all?
Mm-hmm.
Look at all these! This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy. Do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to...
A demon! Luffyset, run! No matter how much it hurts, run!
Velvet!
Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't!
Go! Why is a demon here?
I don't want to go alone.
You have to. Don't let your feelings get in the way, or that thing will kill you too.
But
please,
Dad,
go! It's just like Arthur said. I have to do this!
Stop! Face me, demon!
How did I get home?
Velvet!
Luffy, you're all right.
Sorry, it's all my fault.
No, if you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Scarlet Knight? What's going on? Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't!
Oh!
time to be scared. I have to find Luffy. No. The village.
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lothisek's life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
Go. This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you will not change. Ever a slave to emotion.
Thank you.
feeds on demons.
Arthur.
Atherion.
Arthur!
Take a look around. Demon blight has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorius Colbrand, will end your pain. Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer, Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
I will make you pay!
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years, I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him. And be my brother's vengeance.
Where is he? First, there will be a test.
It will decide if you are worth teaching.
If you are not, I will kill you. Ready yourself.
Burning Wing!
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of...
Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is.
You may find him in the capital city of Logris in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malachim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcists quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcists' Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people, and a sword against demons. Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafiset.
Indeed. But his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
Escape? So that's your game. Fine. I don't care what the world thinks of me. What matters is my vengeance against Artorias. That's all.
I have shattered your yoke. We must hurry.
Thank you.